Can we get any kind of like notes or recording session after the session?
Okay. So you, what I do is generally whatever be the workbooks which I discuss in the class, we upload that to the drive online. I mean, cloud with the Google Drive. We create a folder there, and we share that folder with you. You will get that access, and every day, whatever be the workbooks, whatever I discuss that in the class, I share the same workbook there, and even the task sheets and other some workbooks also. And apart from that, you will get the access to the recordings too. There will be limited access for the recordings too. I mean, I don't want you to completely depend on the recordings. Whatever you have doubts or whatever be the concepts clearance and all, better make sure that you get it done in the classroom itself. That's for just for your reference, for your kind of revision itself. But don't depend on those recordings. Okay?
Yeah. Thank you.
Great. Someone else, please.
Yeah, my name is Mustafa Gibran, and currently I'm working at Google Operations Center as a team lead. So just wanted to, you know, I basically work with Google Sheets, but it's almost similar to Microsoft Excel. So just wanted to, you know, top myself with the latest information and, you know, the work doings and all.
Got it. Yeah. You'll learn those things here. I'll take you to the concepts what I teach here in a while. Okay, someone want to start? It's okay, let me, if you are a bit hesitant, I'll introduce myself. Okay, so, yeah, so I'm Vinod. I have around 10 years of work experience. I have been working with Excel and other tools. And basically I'm a BTech and MBA finance guy. I have worked with the companies like Cognizant, JP Morgan, and some other financial companies. And currently working with one of the product-based company based out of Hyderabad. And I have been into different roles like the data analyst, financial analyst, business analyst, strategic business analyst, and the consultant roles and all. The day in, day out, I use a lot of Excel. I have done lots of process improvements with the help of Excel and lots of automation. It's not only the Excel, the other tools also I keep on using, and it's fun using Excel. Basically, I don't use Excel only for my professional purpose. I use Excel for my personal trackings also. We have lots and lots of templates available, ready-made templates available. I used to build my own templates, but these days we have lots of templates available online. And we can start using them. I mean, we can start customizing them, basically. It's no need to use the template exactly. We can start customizing all those things. Yeah. Coming to this course, this is basically advanced Excel course where it is all about, I mean, let me take you through the concepts of what I teach as a part of this advanced Excel. Let me do one thing. Okay, yeah, one moment. Okay, so as a part of this course, I start with the some basic concepts so that I want to make sure everyone is on the same page. I don't want a few of you don't know Excel, a few of you have few concepts about Excel. If you know few concepts about Excel, the starting first one or two sessions will be a kind of refresher, but you will know some different concepts also there. And I start with the like conditional formatting, like the number formats and the format as table options. And then we go to the formulas. In formulas, I mean, the advanced Excel part. In formulas, I cover date and time formulas, text formulas, lookup formulas, and even the statistical formulas, informational formulas, mathematical formulas, all those things. And then we jump on to the report designing techniques like the dynamic conditional formatting using formulas. We know, everyone know the conditional formatting in Excel. I mean, at least some parts, how to highlight the duplicates and all. But apart from that, I cover using the formulas also, how to highlight the cells when the cell is satisfying particular formula. Okay, and I go with the data management techniques like the sorting and filtering, advanced sorting, I mean custom sorting, advanced filtering, all these options. And then I go to the charting techniques like the different charts available in Excel we have. I take you through that and the pivot tables, and especially in the formulas, I take you through the lookup formulas like VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, and the index functions, match functions, those combination of index and match. And we have some limitations on the VLOOKUP. Those limitations can be met with the help of the index and match combinations, all those things. And the offset functions, all those things. And once those are done, I take you through the dashboards also, with the help of slicers and the timelines, where you can build your own dashboard to present whatever be the analysis you have done to the like the senior management people, where they can take the decisions based on the out of that dashboard. Okay, so these concepts, it takes around 30 hours. Okay, so every day we have a class of 1.5 hour. This is a weekday batch, Monday to Friday. Every day it'll be morning 7:30 to 9. And it'll be of 20 weekdays. So most probably by within a month, we can complete this course. And you'll start seeing that difference starting from the day one. And gradually you see that difference, the way you look at the Excel and the way you learn those concepts. If you are in a very beginner, or even you know Excel, you have been using Excel since long, but you don't know what's going on there within the formulas. So the way, the approach towards Excel will change a lot. That's what the even my earlier batch students also gave me that feedback. So the approach towards Excel will be different from now onwards. Okay? Yeah. Before I start, any doubts? I want to make this session interactive. I don't want it to be one way.
You are saying that we'll start with some...
We start with the basics.
So I'm saying I have new knowledge on Microsoft Excel. Okay, so till now, what the sheet they are sending to us, we used to add some data on the website. Let us say we have some cells or some rows. So when our management, they used to add some data, we used to add the data, but we don't know what is Excel exactly. So my question is, I want to know from A to B, from starting from A to C. That means from starting initial stage, from LKG students, let us take a student who's joining LKG or preschool. there a teacher says it, game is happy, game is more playable.
Got it.
I think you got my intention, what I'm going to say. So I want from that point
yeah. of you know how to open Excel, right?
Yes.
And you have been working with the, I mean, at least you have been reading through the sheets and all.
Yes.
No worries. I'll take you through that. Yeah. I'll start in a while.
See, I have 12 years of experience. Mm-hmm. Till now, I haven't used Excel in a proper way.
It's okay. No problem. I mean, most of this, participants where they are just out of graduation. Or the graduation. I was having one of the participants in the last session. He was fifth standard. He was so interested in Excel, and because his father has been working from home, and he got fascinated with the Excel, and he came to my demo. And it's not that tough, but it comes with the practice. Okay, it's not tough, but it's not only Excel, any tool, it all comes with the practice. So once you have that practice, you'll gain that confidence that leads you to the next level. Okay, yeah. Yes, please. Any doubts online?
As of now.
Yes, please go ahead. Sayed, I can hear you.
No, as of now, we don't have. Yeah, I believe. Yeah, I see.
Okay, great. Yeah. Okay, so let me start with this. So, what is Excel? Okay, it consists of rows and columns, but what is Excel?
Which can accommodate large set of data and help us to analyze some things.
That is usage of Excel. What is Excel?
Data information.
That is also usage of Excel. But basically, what is
Excel is a tool.
Excel is a tool. As I said, Excel is a tool. Excel is a application.
It's a program.
I'm getting some background noise. Okay, thank you. So Excel is basically a tool. It's a software application, like any other application, which is developed by Microsoft. Okay, we have Microsoft Word, Microsoft PowerPoint, and lot many like Outlook, Access, and all, where Excel is a application. So, what are the uses of Excel? Like all you said, we can store data, we can analyze data, we can design some charts, we can use those charts to share that or print all those things. We can do all those things. Okay. So let me quickly create a folder for you guys. This is batch number 295, right?
Do we need to use laptop?
It's no need. Use that for the practice.
Okay.
So I place all the folders, whatever we use here, and just let me do a simple. Let me open a simple workbook. Okay.
I think it's taking some time, but okay. Okay. So as you see here, we use Excel, for storing purpose, for calculation, and for analyzing the data. And Excel was started long back. At the first, it was named as Multiplan in the year 1985. I can say that there are competitors for Excel itself, because they keep coming with a new set of features very frequently, and they compete with themselves. They keep coming with the new functions, new features, new chartings and all. Okay, so basically in Excel, let me open that. Okay, so if I open a simple workbook, this is nothing but a workbook. And the one which I have highlighted is nothing but a cell. Okay, in this cell is nothing but a combination of column and a row. Okay, which is nothing but these vertical selections are nothing but the columns. Okay, and these vertical selections are nothing but the columns, and the horizontal selections is nothing but the rows. Okay, so the cell is nothing but a combination of a column and a row. Okay, not this one, but this one. So you see this, the yellow one is nothing but a combination of J column and a 15th row. So if you see, if you select the cell, the address of that cell is nothing but a J15. J15 is J column and 15th row. So every cell has a unique address in Excel. So coming to this cell, this is having J15. If you see this, it is having N20. Okay. And that is a cell, and these are the columns. Columns are labeled as A, B, C, D and all. And these are nothing but the rows. Rows are labeled as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. And this is a sheet. Like that, we can have multiple sheets. Okay. And this is the collection of all these sheets is nothing but a workbook. We refer that as a file. A few people refer to that as a spreadsheets, all those things. Or everything is same. Okay. Then we have different extensions while we are saving the workbook. Okay. We have .xls, .xlsx, .xlsm, .xlsb in Excel. Okay. And we get some .csv files also. So .csv is a separate extension where we can open that CSV even with the Notepad or Notepad++ or even with the Excel also. Coming to this .xls and all, based on the workbook, based on the version we are using, these are the default extensions available. If you are using the latest versions of Excel, which is nothing but the workbook, which is above Excel above 97, 2003, that means like 2010 or 16 or 19 or Microsoft Office 365 Enterprise Edition, everything will get defaulted to .xlsx. Okay, if you are saving a file, let's say if I am saving this particular file, I want to save this file. If I press Control S to save this, look at this dot extension.
Look at this dot xlsx.
It comes by default, right?
It comes by default based on the version of Excel you are using. Okay, so let me close this. So how to know which version of Excel you are using? Okay, you go to go back, go to file and info. Okay. Sorry, go to account. Okay, in the account you see this here, Microsoft Office Home and Student 2019. So this is the 2019 edition, but it has different versions in 2019 itself. This is like the Office Home and Student edition. If your company is providing that, you will get that Enterprise edition. Okay, but this is 2019 edition. Okay, so that is how you see the version of Excel you are using. Okay, and coming to this, if you are using any versions in 97 to 2003, the default extension is .xls. Right now mine is 2019, right? From 2007 onwards it will be having .xlsx. You might be getting a doubt, what is the difference between .xls and .xlsx? Okay, it's an advanced one. And one more thing is, in the earlier versions, there are lesser number of rows and lesser number of columns. Okay, if I go to the end, the last row, last available row in Excel, in the sheet, which row it is? 10,48,576 row, correct? But in earlier versions, this will be like 65,000 rows itself in a particular sheet. But in the latest versions, you have 10,48,000 rows. And coming to the last column available, what is this column? XFD. That means nothing but, it is nothing but the 16,384 columns we have. In the earlier versions, it was 256. Okay, that is one difference. And the other main difference is, we have macros in Excel. Macros is nothing but a simple program. It's a list of instructions which is written in a VBA language. VBA is nothing but Visual Basic for Applications. So if you have a rigorous task, which is a manual task, where you do day in, day out, and you spend some 1 hour on that, it's different data, but the task you perform on that data is the same. Let's say you're downloading a report from your one of the Office application, from a website, and you have to process that data and you have to submit that report to you have to share that report. So if you're doing that every day, you can automate the task which you are performing. Okay, so you are saving 1 hour of your time every day, which is the companies are looking for, correct? Because
time management.
You are saving a lot of time, and you are not only saving your time, you are saving your colleagues' time and the company's time. Time is money these days, correct? So that all that can be written with the help of VBA language in macros. Okay, coming to the versions we are using here. If you are using the latest version, .xlsx, by default, you can't save macros in that extension. So if you want to save macros, you have to save that in .xlsm extension. Okay? But in .xlsx, only data can be saved, but not the macros. In .xlsm, it can store both data and macros. But coming to .xls in the earlier versions, you can save both data and macros. You might be getting a doubt. .xlsx is the advanced version, but I'm telling I can't save macros in it, correct? Yeah. Microsoft has done that deliberately because macros can do anything. It can harm your system also. Like, let's say someone can collect all the information, just descend the .xlsm file. As soon as you open that file, at the background, they collect all this information, they zip it, they send it to their email address from Outlook or something, and this even delete from the sent items also, so that you don't even have a trace what happened at the background. This all can we do with the help of macros, and we don't know whether it is done or not. Okay, so to avoid all these things, so if you get any .xlx or .xlsm file from unknown resources, if your colleagues are sending you, it's not a problem. But if you are getting from your any unknown source, but first verify that source and look whether the file is important for you or not, and then open that. Until and unless, don't open that. It can do anything. It can be used for the good purposes and it can be used for the bad purposes also. Okay, so to differentiate all these things, Microsoft has done that deliberately, .xlsx and .xlsm, okay, in the advanced versions. Clear? Okay. And you have one more version, one more extension with the .xlsb. .xlsb is nothing but the binary versions. Like, let's say, like banks or the mutual fund companies or the financial companies, they have to maintain the historical records, right? Based on their norms, like 5 years, 10 years. So if I have some file with some 30 MB, okay? I don't use that file, but I just need that file for the future reference. Okay, I have to maintain that as an archival, okay? These days, everyone, we are storing the data online, correct? Or the cloud, because we don't know when the hard disk crashes. So what these companies do is, they say that in .xlsb. .xlsb versions are less memory. Okay, so instead of saving that in the 30 MB, they can be saved in 10 MB. So you are, for per customer, you are saving nearly 20 MB. Correct? Let's say you have some 10 lakh customers. You're saving lots of data, right? But the features are remaining same. Only the data gets saved in the binary format. And when you open that, and you can save it back to the normal format. Okay. So this is mainly used for the storage purposes to reduce the data size. Clear? Okay. So here we have like how many rows, how many columns we have, all that. And in the latest versions, we have 10,48,076 rows and 16,384 columns. And in the earlier versions, we have lesser number of rows and columns. Okay. Okay. Lots of things I have done. Tell me one thing. Let's say I have a simple task for you. I have given a blank sheet for you, and I ask you to start filling the data in the blank sheet. Okay. And let's say I'm just punching my names. Okay. And it takes, I'm entering data manually. Okay. Let's say it takes 1 second to fill one cell. Okay. I'm filling my names like Vinod, Bamshi, all those things. Any guess how much time it takes to fill the entire sheet? How much time it takes to fill all the cells in the sheet, in one sheet? How much time it takes?
Few seconds. You can type your name and drag them.
No. I don't want to drag. I don't want to copy. I don't want to use flash fill and all. I'm entering the data manually as a data entry operator.
Any name or only single name?
Any name, any data, it takes 1 second to fill one cell.
One second. You are saying that we have 1 lakh cells, right?
So those many seconds, correct?
Yes.
Yeah. So how much time, if you convert that into hours or days, how much time it takes?
Yeah.
Any guess, random guess.
Months it will take.
Okay. Any other answer?
16 hours.
Okay. Any other answers? Okay. Let's see. Online. Someone, can you guess how much time it takes? No guessing.
Yeah, depending on the type of data we are doing or typing something.
I'm telling you, whatever be the data you are typing, it takes 1 second to complete one cell. Let's say I'm typing Vinod in 1 second. Okay.
Yeah.
Some random data.
Yeah, I think it's a combination of how many cells and columns are there.
Yeah, cells and how many cells are there? Let's say I have these many rows and these many columns in the sheet. So it's like you're saying, if I have some 30 billion cells, it will take those many seconds, correct?
Exactly.
Oh, let me do a simple calculation there. So how many... If I want to calculate how many cells, I need to just multiply number of rows into number of columns, correct? So this is number of rows and this is number of columns. So it is giving me 17 billion seconds. Okay, forget about that. Let's calculate how many seconds are there in 1 year. Okay, to calculate that, let's come from hierarchical level. How many days in a year has 365? I'm multiplying that. How many hours in a day has
24?
How many minutes in a hour? 60 minutes. How many seconds in a minute?
60.
So if I multiply all these things, I'll get to know how many seconds are there in one particular year. So there are 3,15,36,000 rows, correct? If I want to know how much time it takes, I just need to divide this number with this number, correct? So any guess now, how many years it takes?
Three, four years,
okay. It takes 545 years. So you can pass it on the same sheet with your generations, at least like 5-6 generations.
When you're working on Excel sheets in our office, at a particular time or certain part of time, it shows that your Excel sheet was exceeded the data. You can't enter the data. That means
no. I mean, until and unless if you have copied the cells more than 10,48,576 rows, it won't say that.
In a 15 days or 15 days time or 1 month of time, we used to work on personal Excel sheets, right? Personal sheets, every individual having some personal requirement in some data. So at particular time, let us say 1 month of time or 15 days of time, after entering all the data, it shows that you can still exceeded the data on your
internet.
So please
try
with another
example. I don't know. I never got. We never get that error.
We got the error. That's
right. I mean, how many rows you have in that?
I don't exactly remember.
Do we have? I mean, okay. Let me ask you simply. After, let's say you have filled in all these things continuously, and do you have any blank cells down, blank rows?
No.
Okay. Then it's been exceeded. You are using maybe. You are using more than 10,48,576 rows.
Okay.
If you exceed that, you can't enter. You have to use another sheet.
And is there any chance that if we lost that Excel cells, let us say some Excel is the same sheet, he had locked the cells, not to enter or not to...
Yeah, we can do that.
At that time also, we'll get error, right?
Yeah, we get error. Because... I'll tell you, that comes in the data validation actually.
So we can log the cells. We can restrict the cells to enter only numbers. We can restrict the cells only to enter only the mobile numbers. We can restrict the cells only to enter the date. Let's say I want the users to enter mobile number there. So if I share that sheet with you, you enter some text there, it will throw an error and it won't even allow you to enter. We can restrict that. I'll teach you how to do that using data validation and all. Okay. And in the mobile number also, we can restrict that to the 10-digit mobile number. It's not like I enter only 5 digits and I want to skip the remaining. It's not like that. You have to enter 10 digits. So this is all comes with the data collection. So if you need less time on cleaning your data, once you have the data, you have to prepare your sheets like that. You have to place proper formatting, place proper instructions to the users to fill in the correct data. Okay. Great. So I mean that no one actually do that filling manually, but it's just a thing to say that Excel sheets are large. It's not small, and we can don't think that whatever you see on this screen that is the limit of Excel. No, it's not like that. You can do a lot with Excel. Okay. So coming to the Excel UI part, UI is like, if you see, this is the title bar where you see the name of the workbook, and this is the quick access toolbar. Where is that quick access toolbar for me?
Can you increase the font?
Yeah, let me zoom it. Can you see it now?
Yeah.
Okay, coming to that, next we have this file ribbon insert on all these things. I mean, this is nothing but the ribbon where under each and menu item you have different features which are grouped together. Okay, then under each menu item, you have these groups: clipboard group, font group, alignment group. Coming to the formulas, you have function library here. Coming to the data tab, you have the get and transform data, queries and connections, sorting and filtering. All similar features are grouped together. Okay, that is nothing but the groups, and this is nothing but the name box. Okay, name box is nothing but by default you have the cell address of the selected cell. Let's say I have selected this cell. By default, the name box will display that cell address. And we can do a lot many things with this name box. I'll teach you. And this is the formula bar. Okay, formula bar where we can write the formula, or we can edit the contents in the cell from there directly. Okay. And these are the sheets, these are the columns, as I said, A, B, C, D and all. These are the rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and these are the sheets, index, about Excel, Excel UI, customized QID, all those things. And this is the status bar. If you are running some macros and all, it shows the status. And this is the zoom bar, where you can minimize zoom in and zoom out the view of the Excel. The font won't get increased, only the view will get zoomed in. Okay? Yeah. Any doubts as of now?
No, sir.
Okay, great. So and as we keep on going through the classes, I'll teach you a lot many keyboard shortcuts also. It's very helpful to learn keyboard shortcuts. Every time you don't need to depend on the mouse, and you don't need to, if you are working, continuously with the data and the keyboard, it's easy to switch between few things, right? So I'll teach you a few of these keyboard shortcuts. Let's say if I want to quickly create a new sheet, okay? we have a keyboard shortcut which is Shift F11. If I just press Shift F11, a new sheet will get created. Okay. Similarly, we have many other keyboard shortcuts which I'll take you through that. And I have listed all those things here with the different combinations, like what happens with the when you press Shift, when you press Control plus Shift, and use these things. Okay. You can refer to this sheet, and there are many keyboard shortcuts listed, and I'll teach you while taking you through the classes. Okay, then, yeah. Coming to this. Okay. Yeah, just give me a moment. Okay, let's say we have, let's say this is a small survey which is being conducted, okay, and I want to you to fill in this. Let's say I have Hike Messenger, okay. How many of you, your phones has Hike Messenger installed? No? Anyone online? If your phones have Hike Messenger, I think no. Okay. So the regular usage will be zero because I don't have it installed. Then how can I use? Okay. Coming to Viber. No one.
No.
Okay. Facebook Messenger?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Yes.
Okay. How many of you open it at least once in a day? 1, 2.
Okay. Every once a month I open.
Okay. I'm taking 3. Skype? No.
No.
I'm taking this survey for the phones. No. Regular use is also no. How many of your phones doesn't have WhatsApp? So I'm taking the count as 15. Okay. Don't open WhatsApp. Okay. So what we did here, we just filled in these two columns, right? And let's go to this analysis sheet. Okay. Look at this analysis. Let me zoom in a bit. Okay. So I just filled in this data sheet, these two columns, the instant regular usage columns, and I'm getting this based on the data what I have given there. So it is saying the top applications based on installations, it is WhatsApp, and the number of installations are 15. The based on the usage, it is again WhatsApp, it is 15. And the usage of the usage percentage based on all the applications, WhatsApp is coming to 83%. And we have that showing in the pie chart here. And the number of applications, the installations versus usage is coming here. And here also the top 3 applications,